Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatic channel. Today, I'm going to share a short video on my method of Rit Dyeing G10 scales. There are a lot of different ways to achieve various looks, but I will be explaining what I know. So let's get into it. Step 1 is color choice. What base color you begin with will play a part on the end shade result. I usually prefer light tan or light gray. These, as well as other light colors, can be manipulated through different shades of one color a bit easier. Step 2, I disassemble my knife. Some people hold the knife by the blade and submerge the handle, checking it every so often. Whereas all the knives I've dyed have either been cage bearings or an IKBS loose bearing system, and I believe this would rust out the internals rather quickly. Plus, I always like to use this opportunity to take my knife apart and really learn the internals and the build design from the inside out. Cleaning all moving and oiled parts, tuning detents, and polishing any rough surfaces. Also packing bearings / cages with grease and oil, plus cleaning debris from screws. Third, I submerge the scales in acetone and agitate them well with Q-tips. While the scales are taking their acetone baths, I glove up for the next couple of steps. Then, I also hit the scales with some dish soap and a bristle brush. Now keep the rubber gloves on so you don't reapply finger oils, and to keep the Rit Dye off your skin as well. Step 4 is creating your own color mix. Now, I bring a couple cups of water to a rolling boil, which the Rit Dye must reach a certain temperature to adhere to the G10. Then, I add in about 2 to 3 caps full of Rit Dye. If I want a lighter shade, I can add more water. And if I want a deeper, richer color, I just reduce the water by boiling it down, and you will notice the solution becomes very dark. Step 5 is where the magic takes place, the color application. Personally, I always dip both scales simultaneously, so the same shade is achieved on both scales. Whatever you do, just don't let one scale sit at the bottom while boiling and have the other scale suspended in the solution. This will result in a color variance. I use a hanger and place a kink between the scales to ensure they don't stick together during this step. I submerge the scales entirely and then remove them after about 3 or 4 minutes to check. From the different times comes the different shades. Of course, in a progression from lightest to darkest. So this part is purely personal preference and taste. On my Civivi Durus, I wanted the checkered G10 pattern to still remain visible, so I took it out faster than usual, after about 5 minutes. As for my Mini Archie by Ferrum Forge, I wanted the blue to be solid without any trace of an underlying color, so I ran the scales in the boil for about 8 minutes. In the case of the Steelcraft Mini Glimpse, I used the same exact blue as the Ferrum Forge, but I reduced the water from 2 cups down to about 3/5 of a cup. And this produced a midnight blue color, similar to the New York Yankees baseball cap. For this color today, I'll be using powder blue scales from an artisan cutlery proponent and applying the same race car red dye used on the gray Civivi Durus. I'm aiming for a little darker and richer red. This G10 on the proponent has similar layers like the Durus, but I want the color to come back solid. So let's see how it works out. Now here I'm just dipping and dunking and playing the waiting game. Now after your color has been achieved, we can move on to step 6, which is the cleaning bath. With the same brush and mild soap, I scrub away any buildup of dye that may have formed during the boil and also remove any unwanted particles and debris. And then I place the scales handle side up and let them dry and absorb all the remaining dye. Now I've heard many different things from different people, from don't touch the scales to 36 hours plus, some say 24 hours, and it really doesn't matter. It's whatever you prefer. Personally, I've always moved to step 7 after about 8 hours have passed. And step 7, of course, is reassembly. Now, I always sit my screws out in the layout and fashion in which they were taken out. Meaning, I put my left screws back on the left side, exactly back in the holes and thread they came out of. Now, even if they are the same size, I try not to move anything around from how it was set. Now, if you need to take pictures, do whatever makes you feel comfortable with the disassembly and reassembly process. After this step, and everything is back in working order, step 8 is to just look and feel good, knowing this knife is now your own creation and just that bit more special and personalized. Now, I hope this upload helped everyone who asked about the dyeing process and gives a couple people the encouragement to go ahead and try it out. If there are any more questions on the Rit dyeing process, please jump down below in the comment section and ask. Signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.